We're back for another Heads Up Hyper Series, guys. Last time was pretty crazy versus this guy. We go back right where we stopped last time. We lost that insane last Heads Up. Hopefully, we can get a little bit of revenge on this guy. I mean, that was pretty damn wild. And you're definitely better player than him. He checks back the flop, pre-flop. We're gonna put out a bet here on the flop. And he calls us. I kind of want to put out another bet here on the turn. Like, if he has an 8 or 5 here, I think he has a pretty tough time calling us. So if he bets something like 40, 48, I think we will get the fold from these type of hands. Maybe we bet even like 52 to get like the extra fold out of it. If he has... if he calls this, I'm just giving up. This is just a pure bluff on the queen because I think it's pretty tough for him to call again with the 5.8. But he finds the call and we give it up. So he wins 100 in the first hand. Still like the double barrel a lot. If he called us there with an 8 on the turn, good on him. Because we can still beat a hand like 6-7. Oh, actually, we don't beat 6-7. He had 6-5. Wow, he called the turn there. Surprise. Surprise. But surprised to see that hand, but you know. What can you do? I think he should fold that a lot because otherwise he will be calling too much. Check it back here with the king 10. Actually, this is a spot where he could have raised it up to 60 again, as I said before. Awesome flop for us. Gonna be just calling. We don't really need to protect versus too many things. And also, this is his bluffy sizing as we've talked about in our last series. We will just call the turn again and see what he do in the river. I think he has a decent amount of bluffs here as well. It's just like the king and the queen as the ace and the queen the last hand. It's a good card to double barrel. Pretty dirty river here with the ace of hearts. The flush got there as well as the ace. But I don't think it will turn an ace into a bluff super often. So actually I think about heroing here. And I think I will do that. It's a good play. That is a really good call down the river, I think. Didn't take me too long, but I just felt that he had way more bluffs there with that sizing as well than he should have. Gonna be checking here. This is just a hand that is too nice. I don't want to raise up to 16 and have to fold there. Come on, let's bear it again with your 8-9, dude. I'm down. Bluffy sizing again, and I was right with the bluffy sizing. Pretty crazy. We pick up all diamond draw here on the turn as well. He checks it. I don't think he will bluff the river too often. But he still has better hands than us with the 9, so I guess we want to check it here. And we could have bet like something like 40 and fold to a bet on his side. But he thought about bluffing it, and he had... Come on, hold'em manager, what did he have? He had queen 3. Alright. I'm gonna be limping this one. A little bit of a trap here, and it's a hand that flops really good well. Like that way, by limping here, we got the champ from king 7. Type hands. Flop an open ender. Gutter. Don't need to bet. Make the nuts on the turn, the nice Broadway. Broadway is on, guys. Gonna be betting now. Let's extract some value from him. Hopefully he has check 10, you know. Or like queen 9 and just jams it here. That would be a good one as well. Oh yeah, come on. Rip it in, dude. Another 30 euros for the stream. Top donator. He calls. I like the call. Because we have two options here. We could bet something like 38 and then do the jam on his side. Or we could just go for value. I think we're gonna go for value here. I think we go a little bit bigger than that, 62. If we win this, we have him like absolutely crippled. But he folds. Alright. But still, he's not in good shape. He's down to under 10 big blinds. That's where we want to have him. We also, he hasn't been trapping so much. So this is the reason I would jam the 6-4. Like, he has never limp caught us with a really good hand. He only had folds so far, so I think we really want to jam like 6-4 suited there and take it down pretty a lot. Snapping here with ace-9. Alright, let's hold. Let's hold. No check, no 10. Boom, there we go. Another 30 euros to the stream. Yeah, he just wanted to keep on playing. I'm down. Tournament is over. Oh, that's the new one. That's what I like to see. We're up 30 euros now for today's session. We were up 30 bucks last session as well. This is a little bit buggy here. Come on, PokerStars. I'm gonna be folding the four deuce. I think it's fine to fold like hands like that that are that bad, as I said before. Could be limping the queen four, queen five. Interesting here. We have the queen of clubs, so we can bear it again. But he hasn't folded to a double barrel last time. But I still think that we should go for the bet here. It's kind of close, you know. But it's we have so many backdoor draws, and we can represent so many things. That I really like it. Obviously, we're gonna bet on the ace here. And we haven't gone for a triple barrel bluff versus him yet, but this will change with this hand. I'm definitely like, if the river is not a queen, I will barrel it. I mean, we could check a 5 as well, but I'd rather just take it on there on the turn. Don't have to go for the 3 barrels. Awesome. We also bet like fairly swiftly on the ace. I think that makes it less likely we have a bluff, or at least people assume that, or like perceive it as like that. Perceive it like that? I think perceive it like that. Once again, his bluffy sizing, we will just call. He has check 9 in his bluffing range though. And hopefully he doesn't have that hand, because I'm calling 2 streets here for sure. Alright, I think I want to check call the river. He hasn't been bluffing the rivers too much, but I still think that he has like, we saw the 10-6 earlier, so I think he has a decent amount of 9s here. Let me check, just quickly check what he had there. King check, he had the open ender, didn't bear again on the turn. Gonna be limping the king 4 suited here. I will check it here, even though betting is totally fine. Check's not a great turn. Let's just check it down here. I think we should be quite good here. Alright, we chop it up. Or quite often good, I meant. We'll be jammed the deuces here. It's really unlikely that he has another pocket pair, so we see a lot of folds. Also, like, he hasn't been, like, raise calling too much, so I don't think he has too many good hands in his range, raising range. But he also has, like, so much bullshit in his limping range. Like, he's just a guy that folds too much in general. Which we definitely will take advantage of. We're limping the ace jack, hopefully he jams it. Be a little bit trappy and sneaky with it. We're betting this flop. And if he were to raise it us here, we will just get it in. He could have 2 pair and sets. Not too likely that he has sets though, but he has a lot of like 8, 9, king, queen, and weaker checks obviously. We have the best check. And since we limp free, it doesn't look that like we have ace check. People usually expect you to raise with it. So the ace is not a great card because queen 9 and 9-7 got there, which are both hands that he could have. Even though I think queen 9 is way more likely than 9-7, obviously. So we would just bet a little bit bigger here on the turn. It's a little bit of a scary card. He calls us pretty quickly. So we have kind of a tough decision here on the river. I still think we want to go for value here. Like 92. And get the value from like weaker checks he has. Maybe even a 10. 3 streets of value here. But we take it down, he doesn't call. Like, the last street is debatable with our edge, we could check it as well. Not quite sure what's the best line there. I think the bet is fine though, for the majority of it. We'll be jammed to check 7 now for 9 big blinds. We have 40%, let's suck out on him. No 8, no 9, no 8. Alright, that's another win. Alright, last match for today's session. We up 60 bucks this session. 60 euros, that is much more than $60. Not bad, man. This is not a bad hyper heads up session, guys. I think we're really showing here that you can make a decent chunk of change in these. When you have a guy that you know how to exploit. Just get a little bit of drinks, guys. Today's Sunday, as I said, and I'm going away tomorrow. So I'm actually quite busy today. I have a lot of things on my schedule that I need to work off. Need to upload a bunch of videos. So you guys are entertained while I'm gone. I don't know, man. I really enjoy YouTube. Once again, it's fluffy sizing. Let's see if that is true once more. Yeah, I really do enjoy YouTube lately. And I want to be really consistent with the content. So even if when I take time off, I want to have something that you guys can watch while I'm gone. We went for value there because he doesn't have the river ever. So in case he has the 10, I want to get value there. And he had the 10. Awesome. Also part of the reason we check the ace, we are not perceived to have many ace in our range once we check it, right? Like usually when we have an ace we would raise. So it's always good to just call with an ace and he will try to represent all the aces once you raise pre. We're gonna be defending 6-3 here and I don't know what that is, but we will close it fairly quickly. Sorry for that. 6-3 now on the flop, he checks it back. I would just give up on the queen. The queen is a horrible card. So he just takes it. Let's win this one, man. Let's have a 90 euro profit session instead of the shitty 30 euro session last time. But it was a wild heads-up match, man. Holy moly. I had a good time with that one. King 80 on the flop. I will bet it. It's just the ball is really, really crazy. He will call this with a 10 and a queen and a check. He actually goes for a raise, which I haven't seen yet on his side. I will fold it this here, which is pretty tight, but I just haven't seen it on his side at all. A raise, a check raise on the flop. Just a raise in general, it hasn't happened yet, so we want to be like a re-raise. I will give him much credit for it. He checks back the flop. It's good for us. We check it again in the turn. We'll be calling a bet now. Disgusting river. He will beat us now with the queen. Oh, pocket nines. Okay. Folding. This doesn't go too well, this one. Hopefully, we can run it up here with the queen 10. He raises. We will jam over it. He has a lot of raise folds. This time we're flipping. He has nines again. We need a queen, a 10, or a king. Boom. Haha. Get the run good when we need it. Nice one. Gonna be limp folding queen to suit it. That is awesome. Nice queen on the river. Pew. And we flop a queen again, man. This guy, he is not doing too good versus us. Just jam it in there, dude, with your 9-8. Or your king 5 again. Actually, he rears us with the king 5 there. I remember that spot now. And the 10 is not a good card, but we just bet again. And I mean, the 10 is not like a great card, but it's alright. King Jack got there, but it's about it. And we win another one. We needed a bet there because like the ball is getting redrawy, and we just really want to protect it. A 7 will be a snap here. Come on, 90 euro profit session with 3 heads ups in a row. Let's make it happen, guys. Let's make it happen. He is folding too much as well. He's down 6 big blinds. We almost have him. 10-5 suited. He is most likely a fold. I will quickly have to check the chart. It's fine. You call for 5.2 big blinds. And that's not that one. So, since I want to call tighter anyhow versus him, since he folds so much and makes a lot of mistakes, I only will call when it's profitable by like a big blind or so. That way we can use our edge here. Check 8 will be a call, I'm pretty sure though. Yeah, check 8, we got a call. We have 36% here. Let's get a check on 8. That's a nice river. We chop again. Running a little bit good in all ins in this episode. Last one wasn't too good there. Ace 10, snapping him. He jams quicker again, and once again, he has a better hand. So he really has some sizing tells. 5 king, ace 10, ace on the river. We win 2 flips in this one to win. That was a sick session, guys. We won 3 heads up hypers for a total profit of 90 euros. Can't complain at all. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to check it out from yesterday. Another one will be uploaded tomorrow, guys, so I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe and good luck at the tables.